What's up, guys? This is Chris here from Honest Outlaw, and today we're going to be talking about a really cool pistol. We did a patron vote to see which pistol you guys wanted to see first. I've got a couple of new ones in the stable, and you guys chose this one. I'm pretty excited for that, actually, because I reviewed the original version of this. This is the Steyr L9 A2 MF. The Steyr A2 is one of those guns that most people have no idea even exists because Steyr's marketing campaign is not great. Ever since Die Hard, I think people just assume it's Steyr just stopped making guns, but they certainly still make guns, and they make some pretty good handguns as well. The L9 on the Steyr L9 A2 stands for long version. This, I think, has a 4.5-inch barrel. They come in 4, and they come in smaller than that as well. I think they come in small, medium, and large, and this is the larger version. This is a longer barrel and slide and compact-style grip. Feels like a compact-style grip, although it does hold 17 rounds. Comes with two 17-round magazines. The changes that they made on the Steyr between the original and this one, as far as I'm aware, they're mostly just ergonomic changes. They changed the grip a great deal. So as you can see there, I got the big old fatty grip on there. It actually comes with a bunch of back straps, and then like the HK VP9, my dumb fingers can get out of the case here, they actually come with side panels as well. So you pop the back strap off there via the little takedown pin, and that comes off kind of like a hinge, and then the side panels slide out. So I put in the largest version of the back strap and the side panels. Along with being more customizable, the grip also has a lot more texture on it than the previous version, and it's kind of similar to an MFP 2.0, and I'm obviously a big fan of that if you watch the channel. So it's gonna allow you to get a better grip on the gun, muddy, bloody, sweaty, all that kind of stuff. Plus, just in regular shooting, you're gonna have a little bit better recoil control because you can hold the gun on target. Now, the Steyr has an extremely low bore axis. It is striker fired, it's Palmer frame pistol, and but unlike a lot of guns, it has, again, an extremely low bore axis. You can see there, the gun is barely over my hand at the rear, and then it's got an angled grip like a Glock, so you're gonna have to get used to that. When you present the gun, if you use the 1911s, you're gonna be aiming towards the sky, and then you're gonna have to break your grip down just a little bit more. Front and rear slide serrations are very easy to use, and that's a good thing too, because there isn't a lot of slide to hold on to, very similar to a CZ. Lot of surface area there to put your thumb, and it is textured just a little bit. That is just dying for me to silicone carbide a thumb spot there, which I'll probably do here in the near future. Big old RoboCop style Picatinny rail on the bottom there. The whole gun looks like it's right out of a sci-fi movie, which to me makes it look cool. To some people, they might think that's ugly. The trigger on the gun feels pretty good. The original Steyr had a really good trigger. This one doesn't exactly have an audible reset, which a lot of people I heard complained about. However, the reset does push your finger out, and that does help you get on the gun and have some rapid follow-up shots, which is nice. Slide lock works really well, and it's angled down, which is a kind of a cool little feature. However, I bet that is going to entice me to hold on it like a 1911, and so we might have some slide lock issues, although I do really like that. Magazine release is wide but not extended out at all, so we're gonna have to see if I can operate that quickly or not. Squared off trigger guard with a little bit of serrations on there, and then it has a really good undercut on the trigger guard. So overall, it's a very comfortable and cool looking yet extremely unique gun that is relatively hard to find. These are coming out between $600 and $700 when you can find them, and the most unique and weird part about them that they did not change, which I'm shocked they did not change, is the straight out of 1982 sights they got going on there. It's like a triangular sight with a triangular rear sight, which we talked about in length on the previous gun. Some people like them, some people don't. I don't love them, but they are accurate and you can definitely use them. However, they do make some relatively cheap replacement sights, so if you want one of these guns, you like everything about it but the sights, you can replace them. It reminds me of a lot of one of those original video games, or like the movie Tron or something like that. You're trying to aim up some shit that it seems unnatural until you get used to it. The downside to that, since you have to get used to it, is I shoot so many pistols, I don't have time to get used to it, so you're gonna get what you're gonna get when we go out and shoot. And before we do that, again, I wanna thank my Patreon supporters. Thank you guys very much. It's because of you I get guns like this on the channel, because you help pay for them. You help me pay for the ammunition to feed them, and because of that, we try to go over there and do some exclusive content and hook you guys up with some cool stuff. Again, thanks for voting this gun above the other ones, because this is going to be more fun to shoot than some of the micro compacts that I have coming up. So I'm going to have a lot of fun with this gun today. And if you guys want to sign up for the Patreon squad, all you got to do is go down to the link in the description. And as always, in that description, there is a link to a local shelter in Ames, Iowa. Please get on there and donate to those kids. They could really use your support. A couple dollars goes a long way for them. And it's easy to do. It's a good thing to do. So go down there and donate to those kids.
Now let's go to the range.
What were those hip gyrations you were just doing?
Well, those are private. Those are for you.
Should we start an Outlaw OnlyFans for the hip gyrations?
I get like three people, and those people I wouldn't want, I don't think. So we're gonna start this out at 75 yards because I'm a glutton for punishment, and I want to see how accurate these sights are from a person who hasn't shot them. Like I said, I haven't shot a sight picture like this in 3 years, so we'll see.
Oh boy.
I should quit right now. I should end the video on that. I feel pretty good about that.
Short video. I heard it, but I didn't see it. I'm sorry.
We got no lock back. What a surprise, I called that. Yes, that trigger takes some getting used to. I gotta tell you, the no audible or tactile reset on the thing had me kind of fishing for a reset. And the weird grip and the whole weird ergonomics of the gun set me off there a little bit. But I feel like a mag or two in, we're gonna really enjoy this gun. But it certainly does take some getting used to. You ready? All right, so I'm kind of playing around here. The magwell is easy to insert the mag for sure, but the magazine release is relatively difficult for me to hit. Normally on guns, my thumb is so long, I got the Jack Skellington thumbs, that I can hit the magazine release without breaking my grip too much, although I do have to break my grip a little on this. So that's just something to be aware of. About 50 yards right now, and that cadence of fire is pretty good. I'm pretty happy with that. It takes some getting used to put the triangle in the triangle slot for some reason. Apparently I wasn't good at those little blocks when I was a kid, but the real issue I'm having is you have to break your grip so far over, even further than a clock, which I literally shot a Glock yesterday. So oh, we're out. No lock back again. Dumb thumbs. So it's fast. I just end up always shooting high with it because of the angle of the grip. Warm?
A little hot.
Sorry about that. Might have been the literal 30 rounds I shot out of in a row 5 seconds ago.
True that. Wow, those are hitting me really bad.
That, ladies and gentlemen,
is why you don't wear a bikini when you're shooting.
Yep, I was just gonna mention that. Terran tactical girls have a problem with that.
Do they?
Yep. That and a whole bunch of other things. Nothing like a shell to the boobs to throw off the concentration.
It's true. Also, for some reason, I can never hit the top ones. I don't know why.
Hey, it's just above your head.
Ready?
You're on like Donkey Kong, Mrs. Wick.
Let's someone did call do. Me that. Ooh, yeah.
Damn, girl. What'd you think?
I like it.
Yeah.
It's a lot of fun.
The recoil impulse is really nice on that.
It is really nice.
Especially
and
compared to the dagger.
I really like the Hollow Sun Vulcan because of the arrow. And I feel like this is very reminiscent because it too is an arrow. So that is helping me out a lot. I don't know. I just like big things in my hand.
And that's where we'll end this. So far, I really like, damn, this gun's hot.
It's very hot.
So far, I really like the ergonomics of the gun as far as the grip, the feel of the grip, the texture of the grip. I like the recoil impulse a lot. It's crazy low. It's just, you know, a little bit of a push, barely any muzzle flip whatsoever. There's a couple things I don't like though. I don't like the arrow sights. You do, obviously, because you don't have, you know, 20 some years of ingrained shooting experience with regular sights like I do, I feel like. So I kind of messes with my brain every time I see them. Plus the white arrow pointing toward a bunch of white targets is kind of difficult. So it might be just what we're shooting.
Well, whose fault is that, Outlaw?
I should have just came out and repainted all the targets quickly, I suppose.
You should have.
The trigger, the pull is good. The reset is good, but I'm having a hard time finding it to go too quick, although I did go pretty quick. Overall, I like the gun. It's super, super awkward to shoot the first time. If this was my gun all the time, I don't think I would have any issue with it whatsoever. It was very reliable, accurate out at distance and up close. The recoil impulse, again, is really low. Part of that is because of the longer barrel and just adds a little bit of weight out front. 27 ounce overall weight is a little bit heavier than your average compact pistol, so that helps with the recoil impulse as well. As I said, it's really comfortable, but I have a lot of issues with this gun shooting high, because it's even higher than a Glock. When I present the gun out, I end up going like this and my barrel's pointed at the sky, because that just feels like that's where my grip wants to be for almost every other gun I've ever shot. And instead of going like this, then you have to break your grip down even lower. Not only does that slow down my presentation of the firearm, but it also, every time I fire a round, every time I represent or re-engage, I'm still high again. So a lot of times I'll end up shooting a plate, going slightly over the plate, shooting the plate, slightly over the plate, shooting the plate. And that's gonna take some experience and practice to overcome. So you definitely could, absolutely. It's just an issue with training. However, I shoot so many different guns that it's probably unlikely that I'm gonna overcome that in the time that I have to review this gun. So, not a knock on the gun at all, probably more so a knock on the shooter. However, just be aware of that when you do buy the gun. Super cool, super reliable, good ergonomics. However, maybe not the best gun for people that already have a lot of ingrained pistol reps, I suppose.
I liked it.
Yeah, I know you did. You shot it really well, too. You shot it really, really quickly up close as well. Way quicker than you normally shoot iron sight polymer frame guns.
I like arrows.
Fair enough. If you like arrows, the Steyr A2 L9 MF, motherfucker, is for you. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Please help out the local homeless shelters. And what the fuck? Please help out your local homeless shelters and remember to recycle. I'll check you later. The Long 9 A2 motherfucker, I don't know what it stands for. Try to do a tight close-up on the gun and then bounce back to me.
You want me to do a tight close-up?